Hello, I'm Dan Toppy and welcome back to another brand new Fortnite video. Earlier on today, the Week 5 Season 9 challenges did release for the Battle Pass, and as always, I'm bringing you my full guide on how to complete every challenge from the week. If you haven't seen one of these videos before, what I do is to start off with the hardest challenges first, give you a full guide on how to do those in the quickest and easiest ways possible, and then after that I move on to the easier challenges, give just a few tips on how to do them a little bit quicker and a bit easier, so you can get all these challenges sorted and complete the Battle Pass for the full season. So getting straight into it, starting off with the hardest challenge from this week, and the hardest challenge this week was Battle Pass challenge number 1. This was a racetrack challenge, so it's a 3-stage challenge, there's 3 different racetracks all around the map. All you need to do to complete this challenge is do a lap of all 3 of them. This will have to obviously be done in 3 separate games. On screen now is the map showing the location of all 3 of the tracks around the map, so all you need to do is go to these tracks in order. The first one you need to go to is in the desert, the second one is in the snowy part of the map, and the final one is over in the grassland. As I said, these are all shown on the map now. And once you get to these racetracks, all you need to do is do one full lap. So go to the starting point on the track. Generally, there you can find a vehicle. If not, you can go and find vehicles in other parts of the map. If you are at the desert track, I definitely recommend going and looking at the campsite for other vehicles. For stage 2, go and check over in Happy Hamlet in the sports shop. Here you can normally find a quad bike if all the balls are missing from that track. And finally, over at the grassy track, if there aren't any vehicles left on the track, go and check over in Junk Junction. Here you can usually find one or two. Then all you need to do, like I said, get to the starting point of the track. And once your lap has started, white loops will appear over the track. All you need to do is go through all these to get back to the start, and this will have completed that stage of the challenge, and keep repeating it until you have done all 3 parts. The quickest way to complete this challenge is definitely in the Team Rumble game mode, just because all the players in the game are split in half, only half the players in the game can actually kill you. And if your bus is on the side of the map nearest your racetrack, you'll generally only get your teammates landing there, so it should make it a lot easier. So definitely play in this game mode, it'll make it a lot quicker and easier to do than playing in solos. But once you've completed that challenge, the next hardest challenge to complete this week is Battle Pass challenge number 3. This challenge says visit 5 different wind turbines in a single match. Over on the hills to the south of Pleasant Park, you can find 7 different wind turbines. All you need to do is visit 5 of these in a single game. It does make it quite easy because in between a few of them there are direct zip lines. So on screen now is a map showing the location of all 7 of the wind turbines around the map. The line going between all of them is my recommended route, so if you go around them all in this order, it should be really easy to complete, and especially again if you are playing in the Team Rumble game mode, you do have that glider, so you can glide across those wider gaps and get to that sky base a lot quicker so you can reach that final turbine. And once you've landed on top of all 5 of those turbines, you'll have completed this challenge, and you can then move on to the easy one. So starting off with the first easy challenge from this week, this is free challenge number 1. This says deal 200 damage to opponents with grenades, dynamite or stink bombs. And again, I definitely recommend playing in that Team Rumble game mode, just because you do get those respawns, so you can respawn in and keep user equipment that you've gathered right at the start. When you do spawn into the game, pick up all these grenades straight away as soon as you see them, because once you do get into those big fights, you often won't find these because they are consumable items, so you do need to pick up as many as you can right at the start when you are looting, and then you can use them in the big fights where it shouldn't take too long to get 200 damage with them. Once you've completed that challenge, you can then move on to free challenge number 2, which says search 7 chests in Salty Springs or Frosty Flights. Both these locations are pretty easy to complete the sim because they both have loads of chests in, but obviously Frosty Flights is a little bit quieter than Salty Springs just because it's kind of out of the way and it's in that snowy area where players tend to not play as much. So you can either do this whilst just playing normally, or you can focus on it over at Frosty Flights where you can probably do it pretty quickly. Next is free challenge number 3, and for this all you need to do is get a kill in 5 different games. This will be super easy to complete, just keep playing and you do it in 5 games. After that, Battle Pass challenge number 2 says place a trap item in 5 different matches. This one again is super easy to complete. Traps are really easy to find, especially the spike traps. Just place them down as soon as you find them, don't waste time. As soon as you pick it up, place it down, it'll count towards one of these towards completing the challenge. Once you do this in 5 different games, that's that challenge completed as well. And after that, you've only got one challenge left to complete, and that is Battle Pass challenge number 4. That says get 3 eliminations at sky platforms. So generally just play around those 7 sky platforms all all around the map, people tend to do go towards them, and if you are playing in Team Rumble, usually there is one of these in the final circle, so if you do play in that, players will always be on top of that, respawning and landing on it, so if you do just go and sit on that, you will get loads of kills really easily on top of there. If not, just play on them in solos and stuff like that. Pick up a sniper, because these are really good sniping spots as well, but generally players do like to go up there, because there is good loot, and they are really good for when players are trying to rotate. So if you do see that Storm is moving quite a long way, you know there's lots of players near you, go up there and you should be able to get some easy kills. But once you've done all that, you will have completed all of the Week 5 Season 9 challenges and the Fortnite Battle Royale Battle Pass. If this video has been helpful or you have enjoyed it, please make sure you leave it a like. If you're new here, make sure you subscribe, so we'll be doing these videos for every single week of the Season 9 challenges. So if you do want any more help with this season, make sure you do check them out and subscribe and turn on notifications to know every time I upload a video. If you need help with last week's challenges, make sure you check them out, they are linked on screen now. But thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.